So a little bit about WeatherBug as a company and who we are. WeatherBug is a weather information provider, as you could probably guess by our name. And what makes us different is that we have a network of weather stations. We have around 8,000 weather stations across the United States, 500 in Canada. And those weather stations produce live, real-time information for your neighborhood. So we also gather data from airports, but you know, the WeatherBug network makes it much more granular information for your neighborhood. We also have cameras on a certain number of those weather stations, about 1,500 cameras. And we also added lightning detection to our network just this past year. And we hope to build the most accurate lightning detection network that's available.
So you chose the Android platform to create this app. Tell us a bit about how you came to the technical decision to do that.
So we chose Android platform to build our WeatherBug application. You know, mainly for WeatherBug, since the data is very local, and when you're out walking around with your mobile phone and you want to get the most accurate weather information, you know, we wanted to be able to provide live real-time data to the application. So we built you know, a native application that runs on Android. The data updates every few seconds. You can get maps, you can get your hourly forecasts, your daily forecasts directly from the phone. It's able to run in the background on the phone, and so that we can send severe weather alerts directly to the phone. So no matter where you travel, it uses location-based portions of the phone to automatically gather your location and automatically send you severe weather alerts based on that location.
Yeah, and the strategy is mobile, right? Because weather is something that you really can take mobile. And when a new platform like Android comes out, it's obvious, it's an obvious choice. And it's also, we can do powerful stuff on a platform like Android.
What specific tips and tricks did you use in your application? You mentioned the temperature.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Any other tips or tricks?
Tips and tricks. I'm not sure what. I guess the notification, right? We came up with the. I guess maybe not that clever, right? But using the alarm manager, so we don't use any battery at all. The application starts up, hands off to the notification system, and forgets about it. Then the next time the application needs to update, it will start up. And of course, I think maybe sort of a major thing is our UI. We think we came up with a good idea for us. So you have a very map-centric view, a locate where you can easily switch between locations. So I think maybe the way we do the location switching and the maps and stuff like that.
What's your favorite aspect of the Android development process?
Well, the favorite aspect is it's Java. We love Java, and also that is so easy. It's very easy to set up and it's very easy to get started. I would say, and also that it's a powerful platform. You can do whatever you want to do, and I mean, if you have an idea to develop something, you can do it. For instance, we do a lot on very simple phones that where you are very limited. That's very limited. It's very limited what you can do. So you always have this trade-off. On Android, of course, at some point you have there's some speed and some screen size factors, but you're not. It's a powerful device.
It's a great great phone for getting your app out with the market. You know, being able to be front and center, and for everybody that has the phone to be able to just get your app and you know, get immediate feedback from people. I mean, we have amazing customers that have downloaded it and given us feedback, and you know, we're able to react to that and add features and fix bugs or whatever it is that that people report to us. So It's been a great platform to develop on.
And the good point is the market, because as soon as we have a new release, we just upload that application, and it's available to the user right away. Yeah. And that is not something you can do with other markets or platforms.
Are there any features that you can do in your app that you can't do on other platforms?
Any features that we can do in this app that you can't do on other platforms we have? Now less, but in the beginning, the Android application was actually the sort of the template for all our applications now that we have on other platforms like Windows Mobile and iPhone. So it laid the groundwork for the other applications.
Yeah, user interface wise, the ease of building the user interface, I think, and all the elements behind that are what kind of gave us our impetus to what we're developing across the board, really, for all of our mobile applications.
Yeah, and then of course the widgets we don't have on, we have,
sure,
but not in that way yet. Temperature next to the clock, we don't have that on all platforms, so that is also an Android specific thing. We try to do it, but not all platforms can do it.
Correct, yeah.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, well, I appreciate your time today.
Absolutely.
Have a wonderful conference.
Yeah, great conference. Thanks.